Hi, hello everybody. This is Uma from Success Law Classes. Today we are going to discuss part 5 of the comparative table of IPC and BNS 2023. So let us start section 169 of the IPC deals with public servant unlawfully buying or bidding for property, whereas section 203 of the BNS deals with public servant unlawfully buying or bidding for property. Section 170 of the IPC deals with personating a public servant, whereas section 204 of the BNS deals with personating a public servant. Section 171 of the IPC deals with wearing garb or carrying token used by public servant with fraudulent intent, whereas section 205 of the BNS deals with wearing garb or carrying token used by public servant with fraudulent intent. Section 171A of the IPC deals with candidate electoral right defined, whereas section 169 of the BNS deals with candidate electoral right defined in this section, whereas section 171B of the IPC deals with bribery, whereas section 170 of the BNS deals with bribery. Section 171C of the IPC deals with undue influence at elections, whereas section 171 of the BNS deals with undue influence at elections. Section 171D of the IPC deals with personation at elections, whereas section 172 of the BNS deals with personation at elections. Section 171E of the IPC deals with punishment for bribery, whereas section 173 of the BNS deals with punishment for bribery. Section 171F of the IPC deals with punishment for undue influence or personation at an election. Section 174 of the BNS deals with punishment for undue influence or personation at an election. Section 171G of the IPC deals with false statement in connection with an election, whereas section 175 of the BNS deals with false statement in connection with an election. Section 171H of the Indian Penal Code deals with illegal payment in connection with an election, whereas section 176 of the BNS deals with illegal payments in connection with an election. Section 171I of the IPC deals with failure to keep election accounts, whereas section 177 of BNS deals with failure to keep election accounts. Section 172 of the IPC deals with absconding to avoid service of summons or other proceedings, whereas section 206 of the BNS deals with absconding to avoid service of summons or other proceedings. Section 173 of the IPC deals with preventing service of summons or other proceedings or preventing publication thereof, whereas section 207 of the BNS deals with preventing service of summons or other proceeding or preventing publication thereof. Section 174 of the IPC deals with non-attendance in obedience to an order from public servant, whereas section 208 of the BNS deals with non-attendance in obedience to an order from public servant. Section 174A of the IPC deals with non-appearance in response to a proclamation under section 82 of the Act 2 of 1974, that is CRPC, whereas section 209 of the BNS deals with non-appearance in response to a proclamation under section 82 of the Act, that is BNS of 2023. Section 175 of the IPC deals with omission to produce document or electronic record to public servant by person legally bound to produce it, whereas section 210 of the BNS deals with omission to produce document to public servant by person legally bound to produce it. Section 176 of the IPC deals with omission to give notice or information to public servant by person legally bound to give it. Section 2 level of the BNS deals with omission to give notice or information to public servant by person legally bound to give it. Section 177 of the IPC deals with furnishing false information, whereas Section 212 of the BNS deals with furnishing false information. Section 178 of the IPC deals with refusing oath or affirmation when duly required by public servant to make it, whereas Section 213 of the BNS deals with refusing oath or affirmation when duly required by public servant to make it. Section 179 of the IPC deals with refusing to answer public servant authorized to question, whereas Section 214 of the BNS deals with refusing to answer public servant authorized to question. Section 180 of the IPC deals with refusing to sign statement, whereas Section 215 of the BNS deals with refusing to sign statement. Section 181 of the IPC deals with false statement on oath or affirmation to public servant or person authorized to administer an oath or affirmation. Section 216 of the BNS deals with false statement on oath or affirmation to public servant or person authorized to administer an oath or affirmation. Section 182 of the IPC deals with false information with intent to cause public servant to use his lawful power to the injury of another person. Section 217 of the BNS deals with false information with intent to cause public servant to use his lawful power to the injury of another person. Section 183 of the to the taking of property by the lawful authority of a public servant, whereas Section 218 of the BNS deals resistance to the taking of property by the lawful authority of a public servant. Section 184 of the IPC deals with obstructing sale of property offered for sale by authority of public servant, whereas Section 219 of the BNS deals with obstructing sale of property offered for sale by authority of public servant. Section 185 of the IPC deals with illegal purchase or bid for property offered for sale by authority of public servant, whereas Section 220 of the BNS deals with illegal purchase or bid for property offered for sale by authority of public servant. Section 186 of the IPC deals with obstructing public servant in discharge of public function, whereas Section 221 of the BNS deals with obstructing public servant in discharge of public functions. Section 187 of the IPC deals with omission to assist public servant when bound by law to give assistance, whereas Section 222 of the BNS deals with omission to assist public servant when bound by law to give assistance. Section 188 of the IPC deals with disobedience to order duly promulgated by public servant, whereas Section 223 of the BNS deals with disobedience to order duly promulgated by public servant. Section 189 of the IPC deals with threat of injury to public servant, whereas Section 224 of the BNS deals with threat of injury to public servant. Section 190 of the IPC deals with threat of injury to induce person to refrain from applying for protection to public servant. Section 225 of the BNS deals with threat of injury to induce person to refrain from applying for protection to public servant. Section 191 of the Indian Penal Code deals with giving false evidence, whereas Section 227 of the BNS deals with giving false evidence. Section 192 of the Indian Penal Code deals with fabricating false evidence, whereas Section 228 of the BNS deals with fabricating false evidence. Section 193 of the IPC deals with punishment for false evidence. Section 229 of the BNS deals with punishment for false evidence. Section 194 of the Indian Penal Code deals with giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of capital offence, whereas Section 230 of the BNS deals with giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of capital offence. Section 195 of the IPC deals with giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of offence punishable with imprisonment for life or imprisonment. Whereas Section 231 of the BNS deals with giving or fabricating false evidence with intent to procure conviction of offence punishable with imprisonment for life or imprisonment. Section 195A of the IPC deals with threatening any person to give false evidence, whereas Section 232 of the BNS deals with threatening any person to give false evidence. Section 196 of the IPC deals with using evidence known to be false, whereas Section 233 of the BNS deals with using evidence known to be false. Section 197 of the Indian Penal Code deals with issuing or signing false certificate. Section 234 of the BNS deals with issuing or signing false certificate. Section 198 of the Indian Penal Code deals with using as true a certificate known to be false. Section 235 of the BNS deals with using as true a certificate known to be false. Section 199 of the IPC deals with false statement made in declaration, which is by law receivable as evidence, whereas Section 236 of the BNS deals with false statement made in declaration, which is by law receivable as evidence. Section 200 of the IPC deals with using as true such a declaration known it to be false, whereas Section 237 of the BNS deals with using as true such declaration known it to be false. Section 201 of the IPC deals with causing disappearance of evidence of offence or giving false information to screen offender, whereas Section 238 of the BNS deals with causing disappearance of evidence of offence or giving false information to screen offender. Section 202 of the IPC deals with intentional omission to give information of offence by person bound to inform, whereas Section 239 of the BNS deals with intentional omission to give information of offence by person bound to inform. Section 203 of the IPC deals with giving false information respecting an offence committed, whereas Section 240 of the BNS deals with giving false information respecting an offence committed, whereas Section 204 of the IPC deals with destruction of document or electronic record to prevent its production as evidence, whereas Section 241 of the BNS deals with destruction of document to prevent its production as evidence. Section 205 of the IPC deals with false personation for purpose of act or proceeding in suit or prosecution, whereas Section 242 of the BNS deals with false personation for purpose of act or proceeding in suit or prosecution. Section 206 of the IPC deals with fraudulent removal or concealment of property to prevent its seize as forfeited or in execution, whereas section 243 of the BNS deals with fraudulent removal or concealment of property to prevent its seizure as forfeited or in execution.